This is Driving Wiz5. Huh. Look at this. The Focus ST. Awesome.
Hi, hello there. Welcome to episode 5 of Driving Wizardry. Today we look at stick shifting. As you know, cars come out with a variety of gearboxes. You get automatics, semi-automatics, paddle shifters, PDK, CVT, DSG, KLMNOP, not a transmission, and then the manual transmission, also known as the manual gearbox or a stick shifter. And if you were Klingon, you'd use the words at the bottom of the screen, which I cannot pronounce. But to be fair to them, it is more just a concept, as they use warp drive and have no need for cogs. People who believe in the automatic will tell you that it is an incredible thing to use in traffic. My answer to that is, don't drive in traffic. As a guy who uses a manual transmission, I like to be able to make use of engine braking, which to be fair is also available to a limited degree in a car with a paddle shifter, and then it helps me keep the car in the power band. Good examples of power band are Metallica, Iron Maiden, Disturbed. Get up, come on, get down with the sickness. Open up your hate and the death of an enemy. Get up, come on, get down with the sickness. You must not get up. I think we're gonna go with Disturbed. Oh, stick shifting itself is fairly easy, but you do need the right equipment. And I'll show you exactly what I mean. Okay, so first of all, it is really important when you do stick shifting to use the right sort of stick. This, for instance, won't work. See, if you were driving particular makes of car, for instance, the GTR or any of the Hondas, cars of Japanese origin, you might be inclined to use something like this, a favorite of Rice's everywhere. Again, it is an acquired skill. I'm not particularly good at it, so I stick to a more conventional sort of stick. Now here we go. See? Easy enough to change gears. Stick shifting. Not nearly as hard as it looks. Well, there you have it, that is stick shifting. Next time, I'll be driving a Toyota. So until then, cheers.